Going to talk about how we are trying to use technology to leverage peer pressure. And I mean it in the best of all possible senses. First of all, an idea. One of the things I have sort of been concerned about when I think about student success is that it's almost always completely, what is the institution going to do to save its students? And when I was reading around in the literature, I came across Vincent Tinto, who is largely regarded as the dean of student success. And this quote kind of got my attention, that institutions can't absolve students from responsibility for their own learning. Well, what would that actually mean? What would that actually look like? Another notion that I started getting interested in was ideas of self-efficacy and self-regulation. And the notion that nobody learns from a position of comfort. If we're comfortable, we really don't have a reason or a motivation to try to succeed. So, how can we afflict the comfortable and comfort the afflicted? So we started playing with this a little bit, and then the last thing was just some, when I stumbled into analytics, I was looking at some things and noticed that our students who were using the LMS, students who got a D or an F used the LMS about 40% less than students who got a C or higher every term. And it made us wonder, well, what would happen if we showed students that during the term? So what we ended up doing was creating sort of something we call a check my activity. Now I wanted to show three screens, but I didn't want to use three slides. So I'm flying without a net here with a little bit of a video here. What you can see here is when students log into our Blackboard system, they can see how active they are compared to others. Basically, the green means that they're sort of within the average. Orange would be 20% below, blue would be 20% high. You can see that this is where the course average is, this shows the student, and then they can see how active they are themselves. This, though, is really the killer slide. If the faculty will use the grade center, it will allow students to see how active they are compared to peers who earned the same, higher, or lower grade on any assignment. Now, it does not always follow true that students who earn higher grades use the LMS more. We had a couple people in the range in here that had a little bit lower. I sort of took the approach that students can figure this out. This is an age of the quantified self where we're doing a lot of crowdsourcing with either our diet, our exercise, or our finances. I try to give students a little bit more credit. They can figure those things out. Some people are concerned, though, as to whether or not that would be effective or not. So this is kind of what we have learned about how students go through there. 41% of our students who used the Check My Activity in an opt-in survey said that they were surprised by what it showed them. Another 26% said that it confirmed what they knew. But there were a couple of students who, groups that were sort of still on the fence. I took that as success, that we are at least getting on their radar and raising their awareness. So, that's sort of in just in an opt-in survey. This is since 2010. We get about, I'd say, 10 or 15 of these. Interestingly, we always get the surveys. They start coming in at the beginning of the term. We started on Monday. I'm starting to see a bunch of those come in as well, so it's kind of interesting. Now, this last one has nothing to do with the Check My Activity, but I just wanted to share it with you as sort of a kind of what it means to have sort of a relationship between grades and engagement. So there's sort of four buckets here with a middle in the one. On the left side right here are students, how they are retained. This is from fall 13, the farthest back I can go to show you all three dimensions. Whether or not they had high grades in the LMS and whether or not they were active. As you might expect, the next term in the spring, very high retention rate. As you might expect, a year out in the fall, much lower. The yellow line is, did they come back at any time during the next year, even if they skipped the fall? Down at the bottom right, these are students who had low grades and were not engaged in terms of what they did with the LMS. And by engagement and activity, I'm actually talking about hits and clicks. What can they do in the LMS compared to the average, and then the average hits per user by grade distribution. What was kind of interesting is this borderline area that was too close to call, understandably, and this is a delivered report from Blackboard Analytics, just so you know, and this is our data. But what was kind of interesting is that the students who had low grades and were engaged were retained at slightly higher rates than students who had high grades but were not engaged. I'll leave it to you to decide, you know, which group you might intervene with, but it was an interesting sort of layout of, you know, the relationship between engagement and grades. Thank you very much.